like a board game. It's new fun, and you play it with people. There's a time you get tired and you put it away. Yeah. Then one day you get it out and the pieces are broken.
North Cascades is one of those places that you, during the year, that you really are stoked to find. It's one of those little gold mines that you're guaranteed to go back to year after year. Helicopter drops you off on a 500, 600 vertical foot face, and you ride it, and the risk of an avalanche is always there, but it's just a little bit less there. First time I met Marcus Egge was North Cascade. Got off the plane and there's this funny looking guy standing there. He's already laughing. Marcus, he's just laughed the whole time. He just laughs and laughs and laughs. He's always making you laugh. He's making everybody around you laugh. Real good time.
First time I met Kevin, he'd already had a nickname picked out for me, which I wasn't that fond of. And we hit it off just like that. I could tell we were gonna be friends.
I think the funniest thing I saw was when Ken, our guide, tumbled down about 350 vertical in shooter chutes. He lost everything, his ski, his goggles, his pack.
I've seen his riding on video before, but he really stepped up when it came time to do some of the bigger lines, and I was impressed. He's a good rider. A lot of sitting and waiting, and we put our time in all kinds of places this year, and North Cascades paid off.
Work!
We all kind of came from different spots. Travis from California, Dirksen from Eugene, and McAllister from Eugene. I came from Portland. And we all met up. We've all been friends. And we kind of just go with a different flow. We kind of just have a good time. We ride around, dork out. You know, we're dorks, basically. I've known Travis a long time. I've looked up to him for a long time. Travis is cool. Travis sucks.
The reason I live in Bend is a small town, but it's not just a resort town. It's got other stuff going on, because I'm not just into snowboarding.
Travis is a little pack rat. He has a lot of stuff that he never gets rid of.
I'm project-oriented, whether it's old cars, motorcycles, or just doing stuff around my house. I guess I didn't know. Ben was gonna get a strip club, but the town got some pressure from the local people in the town and they got scared. No, but I actually knew the lady that was gonna open it and I had like a free admission. Jason, he's one of those kids that's just a natural no matter what he's doing.
Knows he's good and doesn't flaunt it.
He's like a Picasso with paint. Put a shovel in his hand and he can make the best booter that you've ever seen. Doesn't want to be have the image of a pro snowboarder. He likes to be undercover.
That's what I like about him most.
He's just nicer than nice.
We were super good friends with a girl Dave was dating, and Dave hated us because he thought Laura liked us more than him. So Dave hated us for the first year that we lived over in Bend. We ended up becoming friends after he realized we weren't after his girlfriend.
I've known Simewski longer than any of these other punks.
If you're really bored, you have nothing to do, he's the guy you want to call up and go like, hey, Marcus, you want to go out? And you go out with him and you're guaranteed to have something happen.
Coming from Oregon, I had an adaption going to Valdez. North Cascades was definitely a warm-up. Valdez is a whole nother level. It was my first year there. You get dropped off, you're talking on the radio, and you're not sure if you're talking about the same area. So you end up dropping down and not being 100% sure. Just to kill or die. Well, there must be something else. All the blame I placed on myself. Behind the tired eyes, the tears go unpaid. Rip the bonds to a tail. Rip the bonds just like a tail. Rip the bonds to a tail. Let the
Josh doesn't talk unless it's about like candy. He's not a man of many words. He sort of lets his writing speak for him.
I don't know if you remember those old Dairy Queen commercials where there's like a boat made of like chocolate, the mountains are vanilla and they're caving in the cherries. That's Dirksen's dream world. He eats candy all the time and he's the smoothest rider I've ever seen. Even when he crashes, you wish you could crash like that. Feel it slipping through my hand. And I don't really care. And it's such an easy plan. Make them all aware. Whisper to the open world. Doesn't need to know. When any of us are around, we always ride together. Everybody's just into riding, you know, we're dorks, basically. We just dork off.
Don't move to Bend, because Mount Bachelor's flat.
move smooth underwater. I know my way around. Everybody knows me. I grew up in this town. Got 1 million, 2 million. I can't remember how many million, millions. And I'm exactly where I wanna be right now. I got a call back from the wishing well. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I got a call back from the wishing well. I don't even have to shoot. I don't even have to aim. Just smile, deal me in. I got 1 million, 2 million. I can't remember how many millions. Millions, I'll tell ya.
The stage was set. Sierra Tahoe, the Free Ride Championship Border Cross. Everyone was there. Palmer, Hetzel, Gillis, Jason McAllister, Jamie Lynn. It was an anything-goes race to the bottom for part of the $75,000 purse and the coveted disco ball trophy. As was expected, Palmer was in his own class throughout the prelims. Untouchable, the pinnacle. In the finals, Palmer edged out Jamie and Kurt Wastel, followed by Jason McAllister, Tom Gillis, and Andy Hetzel, rounding out the field. Coming into the final triple, it's Palmer, Hetzel, Jamie. Oh, Palmer crashes. The pinnacle crumbles, giving Jamie the lead. It's anybody's race. Now Jamie's down. It looks like Hetzel sailing through the finish. Andy was elated over the turn of events and his surprised first-place finish. Palmer was pissed, and Jamie just didn't care. Andy used the prize money to pay off his truck and took home the disco ball trophy.
R-O-C-K-E-T-R-E-A-V-E-S. I come to Valdez because of the mountains and powder, and you can pretty much ski anything you want to here. Get as rowdy as you want. Pepper's a bunch of rock in the snow that you have to weasel through or jump over or take a beating. Up is a bunch of snow racing down a mountain. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. coming back here to Valdez pretty much just to one of the most intense places I've ever rode in my life, and I love it. Safe zone is when you're back down at the bar with your boys having a beer at the end of the day.
I was at the US Open this year, and there's 15,000 people screaming, yelling, all up and down the half pipe. And you do method, and you heard it, you know? There's instant gratification right off the bat.
Yeah.
That's what it's about. You saw Terry Eagle a million feet in the air, 1,000 miles an hour. That's where I saw snowboarding progress right before my eyes.
I thrive off the energies. I bomb atomically. Socrates, philosophies, and hypotheses. Can't define how I be dropping these mockeries. Lyrically perform armed robbery. Flee with the lottery. Possibly they spotted me. Battle scarred, showgun, explosion when my pen hits. Tremendous. Ultraviolet, shine, blind forensics. I inspect, view through the future, see millennium. Killer bees sold 50 gold, 60 platinum. Shackling the masses with drastic rap tactics. Graphic displays melt the steel like blacksmiths. Black Wu jackets, queen bees ease the guns.
When you got like 15 to 20,000 people, it pushes me a lot more in contests. Look at the skateboarding industry, their half pipes are bigger than ours. Those guys on skateboards go just as big as snowboarders do at times.
And, yeah, and
that's wrong. Our boards are twice as big as theirs, twice as fast as theirs. Our feet are connected to the snowboards, and their half pipes are smaller. Like the focus is more on the money and yeah. Just getting the whole event going off the ground, but not really focusing on why the event's there.
There should be a half pipe 20 feet deep.
I still feel like the half pipes are definitely limiting the kids as far as pushing the tricks and the level of tricks, you know, as far as, you know, more spins and more power going into each trick, and that's just because of the half pipes are limiting all the riders.
Take to win, John?
It's a lot of energy, overall performance. You gotta go fast, you have power, a lot of energy.
But, you know, contests aren't always about winning. You know, I've seen a lot of kids go to contests, throw down sick runs, and get the lowest score you've ever seen because, you know, their name's not highlighted or, you know, known amongst everyone, and you know, everyone kind of like, oh, how'd that guy get here? But that kid's stoked, you know, he threw down a sick run in front of everyone. The Olympics, that's definitely huge, et cetera, because it's such a global thing, and you know, they know what the Olympics are about.
I mean, I have a good outlook of what to expect come February during the Olympics, and it's just gonna be the best competition ever. Instead of 15,000 people, there'll be, you know, 200,000 people watching it. And it'll be a little bit different, but.
Yeah, hopefully they have a 20-foot half pipe.
Yeah.
It wasn't a big transition for me to go from Chamonix to come here. It was like, you know, I had a couple of years of warming up, and finally on my virgin trip to Valdez, I was really ready for it, I think. You always got to be worried when you're out there. There's so many things to look out for, so many things to be thinking about, crevasses and sloughs and avalanches. Even when the helicopter is dropping you off, you know, you gotta be worried that you're not gonna get hit by that when he's taking off. Sometimes when you're in the heli, you only have, you know, maybe you get a 30-second or 20-second glance at what you're gonna be riding. We take Polaroids so we have a map of where we're going. So when the heli drops you off at the top, you're standing up there and the hill just rolls over. and you can't see it, you can't see anything. And you know, it's always fun to go with speed. Watching for your safety when you're out there, and all you can do is educate yourself about the mountains. I mean, you don't want to be out there not knowing all the lingo and the terms, and you know, because people are talking you down with the radios sometimes, and you got to know what they're saying. I'd come back here every year. I would live here if I had enough money to afford to heli every day.
Ever since I was like 16, and just traveling around and meeting a lot of different people. It's been a pretty neat experience.
2 o'clock in the morning, the hotel room, I'm feeling low. Look out through the window.
One good friend that I've met is Jani Malmi, who's from Finland. We just got to travel a lot this winter together and snowboard and just cruise around.
Disco rider. People stop disco shit.
Me and Yanni like to ride together because we can push each other and just interested in the same things.
I need her.
Yeah, I like powder a lot, no doubt about that. That's pretty much what I live for, powder skiing or snowboarding.
Valdez is the most fun you'll ever have, but it's probably the most scared you'll ever be.
Slough management is the ability to look at a pitch that you plan on skiing, recognizing the danger zones, recognizing the safety zones, and realizing when you first start down that pitch, you're gonna start a lot of snow going down with you, and you gotta have the ability to read how you're gonna get away from the slough that you create without destroying your beautiful run.
Just look at it, how could you not wanna ride that?
Turns at the top are all time. Probably the best turns that I've ever had in my life. Just deep, no bottom. Just woo. Said to myself, I'm gonna rip it. I'm just gonna have a good time. I looked back, saw the slough. I thought I could beat it, but there's a power there that is unknown, and it just took me. Down the hill, there's a force that takes over that you have no control of. Your body is at their mercy, the mountain's mercy. But you can still totally think, gotta sink a toe edge, gotta sink a toe edge, gotta get my edge in, gotta get my edge in, ow, gotta get my edge in, ouch, that didn't feel good, gotta get an edge in. You're just thinking about edges and gotta stop tumbling. It let me out. I didn't get out of it. It let me out. You're sitting back and you're at the bottom looking up. You're like, I respect that.
face man, they will replenish themselves. Cheat their forget. The power of their source. The Christian.
Don't forget to enter the FLF sweepstakes for your own ticket to ride. Imagine you and your buddy 5 days in Lake Tahoe. New board, boots, bindings, and clothes. On tour to places like Squaw Valley, Sugar Bowl, and the Tahoe backcountry with the pros. Fill out the entry form and get it back to us by January 31st. Includes airfare from anywhere in the continental U.S. and accommodations. Certain dates and restrictions apply.